Hello friends, I am Dr. Manju Sharma and today I will further in our estimate of Thomas Hardy as a writer. Already in the previous lecture I talked about Hardy being a critic of individual. He allows the scope of goodness to all his individuals. And he says that in all his novels, you will find some kind of sadness existing. But this is not because people are bad. It is because destiny works upon them. It is because fate and chance put a person either in a good or in a bad light. But nevertheless, he allows the scope of essential humanity to his individuals. So, in our understanding of Thomas Hardy, we had better look into some excerpts, some expressions which will give an understanding of Thomas Hardy. We are nobody to call him what he is or what he is not. These certainly are artists of very high caliber, but we can make an approximation of their talent by looking into their works. So today I'll take one more excerpt, and that is this. Look at the expression. Time changes everything except something within us. See, this is his style. He would catch you unawares by putting simultaneous paradoxes. What is a paradox? A paradox is a statement in which opposites are used together for a literary experience. And he says, time. You know, so the doer of things, the doer of change is time. Though the sentence begins here, but I would still say that here we feel time personified as the power that changes everything. It has the capacity to work on everything. We all know that time, since the time of every poet, of the most ancient poet, we have read that time has been expressed as a thief, as a changing agent. So also, keeping much in that same fervor, Hardy says that time changes everything. And there is something which is accepting this everything. You know, within this larger whole of everything being changed, still there remains a small thing which is out. As though in the set theory, we have segments which are intersections and sections which are independent. So there is a section which is except something within us. So time can always change something that is outside us, but it is incapable of changing that which lives within us and which is always surprised by change. So this is a very beautiful expression. Kavi lekhak kehna cha rahe hain कि समय सब कुछ बदल देता है, कुछ हमारे में जो होता है उसके अलावा, और जो हम में है वो भी इस परिवर्तन से अवाक रह जाता है. कितना मजा है. देयर इज अ वर्ल्ड आउटसाइड अस एंड देयर इज अ वर्ल्ड विद इन अस, एंड बोथ ऑल द व्हाइल दिस आउटसाइड एंड द इनसाइड इज स्ट्राइकिंग अ बैलेंस. The outside agent, that is time, is all the time wanting to exercise a change on us, and still something within remains unchanged, defying all change. I'll give you an example. Tess has been subjected to sufferings which she never utters. We all know that she is quiet enough to take everything easy. It changes her life. From a girl, she is changed into a widow, into a mother, unwed mother. From an unwed mother, she is transformed into the earning member or the father for the family. And then she becomes the protecting brother to her younger sister. So it has changed everything, but within her, the innate goodness within her doesn't change. And we are surprised by this unchanging aspect of every individual, of our own self, when we act as we are not expected to work. No one could ever, looking at the character sketch of Tess, we would not be in a position to even dream that she would kill someone. And she does kill Alec Diabubble. She kills him. And what gives her that the spirit, the change to kill him? It was her very strong desire to keep her sister away from this doom, the very same doom that she was subjected to. So here we see Hardy as a real artist to make the truthful estimate of human beings. He says that time could change us. We may look changed, but we are always surprised by some acts, by some thoughts that stay unchanged within us. And his characters are real representatives of this philosophy of his, that things might change them from outside and they will surprise us, as also them, their own self, by acting otherwise. Yet another example. Suicide note by a boy who killed himself and his two younger siblings. So an incident, I am not sure where this excerpt has come to me, but it is about a boy who killed himself and killed his younger brothers, two younger brothers. And what note does he write? Done, because we are too many. Look at the spelling of this word, many. If you understand the meaning of this expression, you will understand the pessimism which Hardy can express. He has killed himself. It takes too much of courage, I would say, because to kill oneself is not an easy task. So why did he kill himself? Because he had also killed his two younger brothers. Naturally, you must believe, you must come to estimate this situation. A boy, this is not a man, it's a boy who has killed his younger brothers or sisters, siblings. This boy has acted not as a boy, but as a man. Only a man. We don't expect boys to kill. But he did it, because he writes in his note that he was not only he, but his younger siblings were also many. Now, what is men? Men are creatures who are driven by more passions than other animals do. We have several passions. We have the passions of greed. We have the passions of anger. We have the passions of endless lust. We have several other passion of raping, of all negative kinds. So he says that he could do it because he was many. And to interpret the spelling as having meant many, we would come to understand that there were so many many that feeding their self would have been a trouble. So this is how Hardy, like a cynic, like a prophet, like a seer, make estimates of characters. You will find in the writings of Thomas Hardy characters who are prototypes of the ones since the time the earth came into existence. They are the ones who existed then, are existing now, and will forever exist. And as I told you, he doesn't disallow his humans that scope for goodness. Even a child might kill under the spur of circumstances, under the threat of circumstances, under the pressure of circumstances to kill his siblings. And that should not come as a surprise, as I talked in the previous section of his writings, that everything changes. Time changes everything, except something within us. So you cannot, because man has been the destroyer and vanquisher of all odds. If it is a situation, he would destroy it to tame it under his control. If it is a person as well, he would not hesitate in bringing a standstill to that situation. So this is again for sufficient for today. And since what I am talking about is Thomas Hardy, and since I am talking about a philosophy that is called Hardian philosophy, so philosophy shouldn't be dealt with in a very prolonged sitting. So here I end. If you like my lectures, kindly put a like and also subscribe to our channel, that is the SPCGCA channel. Thank you so much.